I would like to start by asking a simple question to you all. What value defines you? You don't have to give me this answer, just answer yourself. What value defines you? Yeah. We all try to live by different values, but usually there is one which stands out as compared to the other ones. I believe the value which defines me is persistent at the moment. Because persistence is such an important value for me. It allows me to set goals and chase it. Until and unless you don't have anything in mind or set your goals, I don't think so you'll be able to chase them and come to some conclusion. So, basically, persistence exemplifies determination, passion for me. Until and unless you are not persistent, you won't be able to achieve your goals, as I said. We live on this motherland called Earth for a short period of time. And when I die, I want to be remembered as a person who has lived her life boldly and who had created a name, a niche in the world of adventure. Guys, I'm getting confused, sorry. Okay, so whenever I do something, I'm a very imaginative person. I imagine things and get onto that. Okay, I'll start off with my background. I belong to a business class family, which was very, very comfortable. I used to get everything, whatever I wanted, without even asking for it. And then being the youngest among four siblings, I was more of a quiet person. I never used to talk. I was more introvert. I was like, I never wanted to go out of my comfort zone and do things. But as I got into adventure, everything changed for me, my mindset. And I realized one thing, until and unless you don't go out of your comfort zone, you cannot achieve anything in life. When I got married, it was very difficult initially for me to get into base jumping, go dive, because I have a family. Then I learned one thing, that once you go for adventure, you have to detach yourself from the other people and continue with your adventure. Because until and unless you carry your family or anybody in your head, you will not be able to attain whatever you go for. Okay, when I told you, when I was a child, I was more of a comfort child, never used to venture out. But as I got older, I realized how much I enjoy using my imagination and bringing it to reality. Because until and unless you don't imagine, you cannot pursue doing those things. So my family has been a great importance to me, and sometimes I value very strongly. Okay. So the first step in my adventure was I went for mountaineering. That time, that was the first thing when I went outside my house and stayed alone for a month. And that was the time I realized if you have to do something, you have to have your mind. You have to have that mind. I mean, you have to be really, you have to put in your effort, basically. You can't carry your, all whatever you have been brought up like. Okay. Then, I'm so sorry, guys. I don't know why I'm getting so...
No, you have... I have done one sky jump and I thought that, you know, I'll die. So. You've done 350. Love your dress. It feels like you're wearing a parachute. Just relax. You all are doing it.
Okay, I'll just start off. Okay. See, I was born in a business class family where I never used to venture out much. So, being the youngest sibling, I was very introvert, as I told you. I never used to talk to people. I never used to go out much. I was more in a protected family. And then suddenly I got into mountaineering, and that was the time when I realized that no, if you want to achieve anything in life, you have to go out of your way and achieve it. Now you cannot achieve anything being in your comfort zone. Like there's a story of a butterfly, okay? A man, he found a cocoon of butterfly. So one day he saw a small opening. So he sat and started watching that butterfly, who was struggling to come out from that small hole. But after struggling for some time, she couldn't do anything and she stopped. So this man, he thought, okay fine, let me help her with something. So he took a pair of scissors, snipped off the cocoon and made easy for that butterfly to come out. But he didn't realize what he's done. This butterfly, when she came out, she had a swollen body and shivered wings. This butterfly could not fly. So this guy kept watching her with the hope that suddenly that the wings would enlarge and the butterfly would be able to support the body and fly. But then that never happened. Whole life the butterfly was crawling around. Then this man thought, what have I done? What wrong have I done? So then he realized that because of his kindness, he has done her harm. The butterfly, when she struggles to come out of that cocoon, okay, there is, when she puts the forces, there is a fluid in her body which comes to her wings, and the struggle which she puts in, that makes her come out and start flying. So same way in our lives, we have to go through some struggles to achieve what we want. We cannot have anything in our comfort zone. So there are roadblocks, there are a lot of things which you have to overcome. So during my skydive, when I was skydiving, a lot of things used to happen. Like sometimes I was not able to perform as it was required, because in skydiving you have 8 levels to perform. Until and unless you don't finish those 8 levels, you don't get certified. So there are some maneuvers which is very difficult to do in this in the air rather than on the land. I mean, land you have to take turns, you can easily take turns, but not in the air. So when I used to go, I used to try, and sometimes I was not able to perform. So then, until and unless I used to perform and get over that level, you cannot get certified. So a lot of times I had to do the levels again and again. So this was preparing for my first dive, where you have 2 instructors. It seems very easy here to perform, to do everything. But once you are in here, it becomes really difficult. So this is when I was diving with my 2 instructors for the first jump. Okay, this is your last jump with a single instructor. This is your maneuvers in the air. Total 8 levels to qualify. And this was my last jump when I went for the first time to learn. This was my 51st jump and I got B grade. I mean, there are different levels, A grading, B grading, C grading. So this is B level, where you have to finish 51 jumps, and this was my best jump. And thereafter, I've been skydiving in different countries, in school. In Laos, I have gone, they were celebrating 150th year. So one fine day, while I was doing skydiving, I thought, okay, fine, let me try something more daring. And I got into base jumping. So when I thought of getting into adventure, into base jumping, my parents were pretty, my parents, my in-laws, they were pretty against it because as it is, it was dangerous. And moreover, my in-laws, they wanted me to become a teacher and look after the family, kids, my husband, and be inside basically the house. And my parents were like, they were more scared that, you know, something can go wrong. And if you have, our Indian mentalities are like, if you have kids, anything can go wrong. And what is going to happen to your family after that? But then, by the time I started this, I had already become very strong. My mindset had already changed. I was outgoing, I was outspoken. I used to talk my mind. Whatever used to be there, I used to do that. So this was base jumping. Okay. Now, base jumping is one of the dangerous sports where you can actually lose your life. And a lot of times it has so happened that I have encountered death. I'll give you a small incident. I was in KL Tower jumping and I had gone, they have this 4 days festival there. So I went there and the first day when I had to jump, the winds were pretty high. And the parachute I had taken, it was pretty big for my size. So the moment I jumped, it was windy. My parachute got entangled in a tree. And the moment I came down, and when you're flying a parachute, it is really fast. I mean, you can't control if the things go wrong. So I came down with a force and somehow I was managed to stop myself with my feet. And I got injured. And that was the first jump in that season, though it was for 4 days. So the first day I got injured. And after that, I couldn't jump. But the last day again, I went and I made a jump because I never wanted to come with those memories of getting injured. With that situation only, I went and jumped. So that was how my mind had been made after, you know, getting into adventure. So these were the things which I was doing for basically myself. Skydiving because I'm not teaching. Base jumping, I'm not teaching, I can't teach. So thereafter, I thought, okay, fine, let me get into something where I can actually help people to overcome fear. Because the background I was from, to the level I had become, I knew how to overcome my fear. So I said, let me start with a scuba diving instructor. And now I try to get more and more people in scuba diving, not because of anything else, just because I wanted to make them do something and break their fears which they have in their mind. It is not about anything else. So I generally teach disabled divers also, I mean the people who are disabled, special kids, I teach them scuba diving and I've done a few camps with them. And the school students and it is actually an activity where you can actually overcome your fear and you can learn a lot. It's not about overcoming one fear. It is like you have to overcome a lot of fears in life. It can be even a driving a car. So the moment you learn how to overcome your fears, I think life becomes much more interesting and easy. So this is, I've been diving all over. So sometimes struggles are exactly what we need in life. Until and unless we don't struggle, we don't achieve anything. So basically, I link experiences to piece of experience, my experiences, to a piece of giant life puzzle. Each piece we gather and fit into the puzzle adds clarity to our life puzzle and helps us make better decisions. Thank you so much.